When the leaves turn and the temperature drops, it's time to prepare your yard for winter. It's important to blow out your sprinkler system before the first hard freeze in your region. Rachio makes it easy for you and your sprinkler professional to prepare your pipes for their long winter nap. Water expands when it freezes, so any water trapped in your system during a hard or extended freeze can cause a lot of damage. The best way to prevent costly springtime repairs is to perform a blowout, which uses compressed air to remove water from the outdoor pipes, valves, and underground lines. If you haven't winterized a sprinkler system before, know that blowing out your system requires a high volume of pressurized air. An ordinary residential air compressor might be fine for pumping up tires or operating pneumatic tools, but they lack the air volume necessary to push all of the water out of your pipes. An irrigation professional will use a high volume air compressor configured to the correct pressure to avoid risking damage to your plumbing. If you need to locate an irrigation professional, start with the Rachio Pro Finder. If you work with an irrigation professional who is new to Rachio, share this video with them. Our support team is happy to answer any questions before you begin the blowout process. The professional you choose will request access to your controller to speed up the blowout. Share access with them from the More menu in the Rachio app. The system can be winterized with any level of shared access. When it's time to begin, fire up the app and put your Rachio in standby mode. This will disable all active watering schedules, but your controller will stay online so everything is ready to go in the spring. Quick Run can be used to winterize the system while it's in standby mode. The rest of the winterization process can be completed in 4 steps. Turn off the water, set up the air compressor, blow out the system, then drain the backflow preventer. Step 1. Turn off the water. After parking your controller in standby mode, find the water shutoff valve for your sprinkler system. It should be somewhere in your basement or crawl space. Use it to turn off the water supply. 2. Start the air compressor, then set it between 60 and 80 pounds of pressure. Run the air hose over to the backflow preventer. If you have a Rachio wireless flow meter, simply leave it in place. Our wireless flow meter doesn't have moving parts, so compressed air at these pressures won't hurt anything. Blow it out with the rest of your system. Before attaching the air hose, close both of the shutoff valves at the backflow preventer. We'll drain that part of the pipe later. Attach the air hose to one of the test cock valves. You may need to purchase a fitting that's compatible with your test cock and air hose. Slowly open the test cock valve with a screwdriver, and you're ready for step 3. Start Quick Run and blow out the system. In the app, tap Quick Run and select all zones. Pick a longer run time. Between 5 and 10 minutes should be more than enough. When the first zone is running, slowly open the air valve. Watch the zone blow out. When all the sprinkler heads in the zone spray fog instead of water, manually advance Quick Run to the next zone. If one or two heads are still spraying water after 4 or 5 minutes, take note and blow out the zone again at the end. You won't be able to see water blow out of the drip zone, but you can hear it. Listen carefully. The line is clear when the gurgling noise changes to a hiss. Check each zone as you go, and when you've blown out the last zone, step back to re-blow any sluggish areas. When all zones are clear, remove the air hose from the backflow preventer, and then end the quick run cycle. A zone should always be active while the air compressor is attached, otherwise you may overpressurize your pipes and valves. Finally, step 4. Drain the backflow preventer and feed pipe. Crack open all the outdoor valves and test cocks halfway. This protects the valves and allows the system to breathe a little during the winter. Go back inside and locate the drain near the shutoff valve. Open it to drain the last of the water from your system. Leave the controller in standby mode until you're ready to resume watering in the spring. Your yard is now ready for a worry-free winter.